are watching 8-Bit Days a Week, and I'm gonna be playing In the Hunt. This game actually had a PlayStation 1 port. It's actually one of those early titles. And the art style reminds me of Metal Slug. It's sort of a shooter. It's kind of unique though. You're on a submarine. And let's see how it goes. So, as you can see, I can shoot forward and upward. I can do depth charges as well for the ones behind. And my sub is only facing right. Unless there's a way to make him face left that I'm not aware of. And like I said, this also came out on the PlayStation 1 as an early title. So it's just really an arcade port. If you enjoy 2D sprite art, this is a game to look out for. Also has two player, I believe. And loading the arcade ROM, I believe, is a much better option for this one. It essentially removes the loading times. And unlimited continues. I'm doing bad. My way through the game. Man, there's a lot of things to avoid here. Almost like a 2D bullet hell. I mean, horizontal bullet hell. Just zip your way past. You really have to stop and shoot from time to time. I'm not really good at this game, but the sub is kinda, he's slow, so it's not that simple to control. And if you make mistakes with the timing of your shooting, you might end up not being able to shoot and counter the incoming rockets. And as you can see, you also have to deal with enemies from places you cannot even reach. You can still shoot them though. Anyway, at this point, I'm just abusing my unlimited credits to get through the game. Pretty neat sprite arts. a solid 60 frames per second, despite having lots of things going on the screen. So I'd say this is a good pick to put on your thumb drive. You know, instead of the PS1 ISO. Unlike, say, you know, like for example, the Darius Gaiden had lots of slowdowns on its arcade version, so that one, I recommend the PS1 version instead. But this one, again, reminds me of the style, at least, reminds me of the Metal Slug series. And looks good. Anyway, this is once again In the Hunt. Arcade shooter from Irem, I believe. And this is the arcade version, not the PS1 port. This had a PS1 port once again, unlike the other games I've been playing also. Please leave it in the comments and like and subscribe, and thanks for watching.